Service, the federal agency with jurisdiction over Humphrey. Mr. Lecky, this guy seems to have you stumped.
He sure does. We thought we had him down the river, and he decided to balk today, and time to regroup.
Why'd you call off the rescue effort?
We felt that it was very stressful for Humphrey. He's tired, we're tired. We felt we were in a no-progress situation, and that it wasn't worth placing the animal under that stress in that situation.
So, Mr. Norris, you all gather together, I guess, tomorrow to try to figure out where to go from here. What are you going to advise?
Well, I think that if you leave Humphrey up the river, he'll certainly ultimately die, so that sometime down the line there has to be another attempt made to move him back down the river. And it seems to me that one of the problems is to try and control where he goes at night. I gather that he can be moved during the day. He was moving very well when I saw him last up the river, but that was during daylight hours, and it certainly must be frustrating indeed to have all your work undone by having the whale turn around and go back up the river again.
All right.
Yeah, Ken, one of the things I think we're going to explore are alternatives for 24-hour operations. I missed you the first day and wanted to take this opportunity to thank you for all your help that first day.
Well, you say 24-hour operations. What can you do at night? You can't see him.
We've got a radio tag on him. If we can get the proper equipment and perhaps follow him, know where he is at night, somehow reduce the number of vessels. I don't know. That's one of the things we need to do in our brainstorming session is consider alternatives.
All right. Mr. Norris, how much time is left?
Well, that's really hard to say. When I saw him a day ago, I was impressed with how healthy he looked in terms of his reactions, and his skin looked pretty good to me. I'd expect to see some of the tattering of the skid when it begins to slough, but that didn't seem to be the case with me.
Is that the real danger that is to his skin now or to his system? I understand they can't take fresh water very well.
Well, we don't really know about the big baleen whales. When you put a dolphin, or at least when you put some species of dolphins in fresh water for a long time, they'll start to drop pieces of their skin, and it's very difficult to get them to survive after that starts. But we really don't know what happens to a baleen whale, the big giants like this, because no one's ever had experience before.
Mr. Lecky, the thing that strikes me about all this, whenever you talk to somebody about the Humphrey case, everybody has a different suggestion. Ken Kashiwahara outlined some of them in the piece. What kinds of suggestions are you getting?
Oh, we're getting some pretty bizarre ones, some pretty practical ones. Turns out I think the only ones that are really effective are the obnoxious noises like banging on pipes and driving them down the river.
What else have people suggested?
Oh, we've got somebody suggested dragging a side of beef down the river from a helicopter. I presume they assumed that this was a carnivorous animal. We got some real cute ones from some little kids. One five-year-old boy wrote in suggesting we construct mini submarines made like killer whales and chase the humpback whale down the river.
Can you just tow him? Can you push him? Can you nudge him? Can you get a boat to give him some room?
Could I put a word in here?
Sure.
Method that was working, it seemed to me, up the river was the borrowed from the Oikomi driving system in Japan, where they drive dolphins and whales, small whales, ashore in their fishery. And what they do is to form a semicircle behind the whale with these pipes, which they then bang on, which make a noise underwater that the whale doesn't like. And the method is to try and give the whale some directional cue about where to go. You can make all the noise you want, but if the whale doesn't know what it means, he's as liable to go upstream as down. So by circling behind the animal, you hope to direct it, and that seemed to be working to me when I was on the river.
So, Mr. Lecky, why'd you quit that?
That's exactly the technique we used, and it was successful. The whale established a pattern of being driven through a barrier, progressing up back to that barrier at night, and somehow relating to it. We're in a part of the river now where there's no barrier to push him to go through, to hold him.
And he just doesn't seem to want to go.
Right. And the river gets bigger, too, and it gets more difficult.
It strikes me in all of this that you really just don't know a whole lot about what motivates these guys or what makes them tick or why he would do this. Mr. Norris?
Well, I think it's real hard to find out what goes on inside of the mind of a 40-ton whale. You have almost no chance to learn, really, because they're, how do you do that, you know, out in the ocean? We have lots of guesses about it, but we really don't know very much about what goes on in the mind of whales. This animal was migrating south and somehow or other took a wrong turn. It could be sick. Who knows? We don't know for sure.
Mr. Lecky, do you have a sense that this animal is sick? Somebody mentioned in the piece that he's either brain damaged or insane. Is that a reasonable theory?
Well, there's lots of theories. I agree with Dr. Norris's assessment that the animal appeared very healthy today. His blows are very strong and powerful. Certainly he was swimming very well in the river yesterday. We had him up to about 5 knots. He looks pretty good.
Just before we stop, Mr. Lecky, let me ask you, what's the prognosis? Is this whale going to get out? Is he going to be all right?
Well, I think we've freed him from behind a couple of barriers. I don't think he perceives Rio Vista Bridge as a barrier anymore. He went back and forth underneath it several times the night that he stayed there. Hopefully he'll make up his mind to turn around and go out on his own.
How far from sea is he now?
About 40 miles.
Mr. Norris, what do you think? Is this animal going to make it?
Well, I think he looks pretty good now, so that there's a little time left still. I still think he needs directional information about how to get out, because I have a strong feeling that he doesn't know where he is. He's in very murky water, and he needs directional assistance to point him to the Golden Gate.
And the problem you work on tomorrow is to how to give him that directional information. Yeah. And after 2 weeks, we still don't know. Mr. Lecky,
can I interrupt you for a second?
Sure.
I'd like to ask Ken what he thinks about tidal influence. He's in a part of the river now where it's brackish water and subjected to a much greater tidal influence.
Will the tides help him? Very quickly, Mr. Norris.
I really don't know the answer to that, Jim.
All right.
I just don't.
On that unknown, we're going to have to stop. I thank you both for joining us. When we come back, we're going to turn to our other topic tonight, the nation's newest state lottery. Like many things California, and there's been a heavy share of hoopla and hype, and tonight the lottery picked its first two...
Roy Whale is still concerning all the experts tonight. He's still wandering in the Sacramento River. He's just off Decker Island, north of Rio Vista right now. And marine mammal experts tried all day to attach a radio transmitter to Humphrey's back so they could track his movements, but Humphrey and the waves were too much. Just about an hour ago, the 45-foot whale started making several deep water dives. The dives brought the experts rushing back to the river because Humphrey hasn't done any deep diving before. They don't know if he's diving for fun or if he has some kind of problem, and they're concerned that the river isn't deep enough for the 45-foot whale, the size of a bus, to safely dive in. Today was supposed to be the day of rest for Humphrey, who's now spent 16 days away from the Pacific Ocean. It was not a day of rest. It was a day of a lot of work or fun, depending upon how Humphrey the whale looks at it. He's still out there tonight, and they're still very concerned about it.
A lot of people with their fingers crossed on that one.